Hello students, on the request of one of my students, let us solve a problem from GATE 2000. The problem says a left-handed moldable plow bottom has a draft of 1.96 kN when it operates without side draft. The thrust on the left side is 590 N and the coefficient of soil metal friction is 0.35. What will be the change in draft if the plow is pulled at an angle of 10 degrees towards the right side of the plow? The useful soil reaction forces remain unchanged. Basically, this problem is little tricky. You should know the basics of different tillage forces acting on the moldable plow, basically the soil useful forces and some of the parasitic forces which are coming when the moldable plow is operated. Quickly, let us have a brief on these different forces and let us try to solve the problem. Since in the problem it's given it's a left-handed moldable plow. So basically, if you see most of the moldable plows, they are right-handed. Or you can say when we move the moldable plow in the forward direction, it cuts the soil here in this portion in the shear point, and it moves the soil towards the right side in the case of right-handed moldable plow. In this case, it's given a left-handed moldable plow, so the soil will be moving to the thrown to the left side of the plow. Left side of the forward direction or forward travel of the implement or plow. Basically, this is done in the case of two-way plow. Let us have this is left and this is right for your kind convenience. In this case, it is given the draft. Let us draft is this much. This is the horizontal component in the direction of the travel of all the forces. So now, Px is given, or you can say here we will say Px is the draft, which is given as 1.96 kN, or we can say 1.1960 N, and also it's given thrust is given 590 N. Thrust is nothing but the force acting on normal to the length side. Let us see like this. This is the thrust force acting on the length side. It's given 590 N, and since there is a soil metal friction, it's given 0.35 is the coefficient. This one we know according to the frictional force. The frictional force will be acting in this direction as multiplication of normal force into frictional coefficient. Now, if you consider these two forces, thrust and frictional force, and the resultant will be all the QH, you can say. Resultant will be QH, which is called the resultant of thrust and frictional force, which is called the parasitic forces from this. Now, we can find out this. Let us find out the QH, which is parasitic forces, it is square root of 590 is the thrust, and Q the frictional force is 590 into 0.35 square. Then you can find out the amount is 625.09 N. So QH is calculated. Now we know the QH, and this is the parasitic forces. Now we know the there are all the forces, resultant of all the forces which are called the useful forces. So this QH is the resultant of all the parasitic forces, and RH is the resultant of all the useful forces, which includes cutting, breaking and throwing the soil from the mouldable plug. Therefore, if we know that the point which intersects the QH and RH, or the parasitic forces and useful forces, this is called the edge, or called the center of resistance. Edge is called the center of resistance where all the forces act. That means the resultant of parasitic forces and resultant of useful forces acts at a point H. And also at that point, the draft, in this case, since there is no side draft is given, therefore this QH, the vertical component of this QH is counterbalanced by the side draft, so there is no side draft. The force given by the land side, that is counterbalanced, so there is no side draft. So if you see, and we can calculate like QH and RH, the resultant of these parasitic forces and useful forces, the PX, or the horizontal component of the draft, can be find out. This is the case when there is no side draft. Basically, you can know other things like PX, or the side draft, draft is equivalent to resultant of QH and RH. If in this case, which is given, because the draft is given 1960 Newton, and RH, QH, from these two, QH is already calculated here. Therefore, putting this, we can find out RH square plus 625.1, we calculated here from this resultant of parasitic forces, and equating with, you can find out the RH, or the soil reaction, all the useful forces, which 1857.6 Newton. So this is the useful forces from this problem. Why we calculate these useful forces? Because in the second part it says that if something happens but the useful force remains constant. Therefore, what is the useful forces? If you see, the useful forces coming from two resultant of two things. One is side force and another is horizontal component or draft force. So this is the component from where it comes actually. L and S, RH comes. This is for your reference, though we don't need here. Now actually, once we find out this RH, we can find out the angle between RH, or the soil reaction force, and PX is the draft. Here the draft and the pulling line is same. Therefore, there is no side draft in this case, first case. That's why the theta can be easily calculated, because if you see the QH and RH, the resultant is PX. If you see this, the forces, two forces, QH and RH, you can find out theta in this case. So this one is also QH, this one is QH. From this triangle, if you see, this is a 90 degree triangle, this one here, this is 90 degree, okay, since it's 90 degree here, RH, if you find out theta, tan theta will be equal to QH divided by RH. So QH is known and RH is also known. Therefore, we can easily find out theta from this. So theta can be tan inverse 625.1 divided by 1857.6, that is 18.6 degree. This is theta, the angle between the RH, or the resultant of all useful forces, and the draft. Next is, since we find out this draft angle to the soil reaction plus RH. Now it says that if the draft the mold wood is pulled at an angle of 10 degree right side of the plow. So if this is the initial one, the draft, or this is the line of pull initially, but now the pull is little different. That is right side is this one, or remember this is right, this is left, already we defined, this is the line of travel. So if this is Px, we find out, and this one is the horizontal component, or you can say PH, which is the pulling line of the moldable plow, which is says it is 10 degree from the line initial point. So this is right side of the PX. So let us say it's a PH, horizontal component of the pull. Therefore, this one is known. Now, since it says that RH or the useful soil reaction forces remains same, but since it is little tilted or it is angled pull, the QH or the resultant of parasitic forces will change. Basically, it will increase because the land side will be giving more thrust to the wall of the soil, and also the draft will change or PX will change in this case. Since initially PX would be like on this line, but here actually the PX is line is this way. Therefore, if you see this is RH remains same and QH change, QH should be little higher. Maybe this is QH and this is RH. RH is almost same, which we already calculated 1857.6 Newton. Now what we will see, you know the resultant of QH and RH will be PH, because this is the line of pull. Now this PH we have to find out first, since we know RH. It's very easy to find out pH first. Before that, actually already we know the angle between RH and PX. This angle. Let us see this H, and this angle between RH and PX is 18.6 degree, and 10 degree it is already tilted. So the total angle from this to this is 28.6 degree. So that is 18.6 plus 10 degree. So this is total. This angle is 28.6 degree. Therefore, we know this RH is the component of pH. So if you see pH cos theta, which is this angle 28.6, is equal to RH. And RH is already known. We don't bother about QH. Definitely QH will change, but we don't want to find out QH in this case. Therefore, PH will be PH cos theta, that is theta is 18.6 plus 10, 28.6 in this case. That is 1857.6 is RH, that remains constant as per the problem. Therefore, PH is equal to 2115.75. Newton. Now, once you know this pH, and this is the angle between PX and PH, if we consider PX is the pull or draft, then draft PX can be found out easily from PH, because the angle between PH and PX, if you see this, this is the triangle, 90 degree triangle, and this is the theta. Theta is 10 degree. In this case, then PX will be equal to, PX is draft in this case, So draft will be equal to PH cos theta. Theta is 10 degree here. Then you can find out the draft is 82.93 Newton. So this is the new draft when the plow is pulled at 10 degree angle right side of the moldboard. This is the line of travel and this is the right side. This is the 10 degree given. You can find out the draft horizontal component of this one force PH is PX is 2082.93 Newton. Therefore, the change in draft or percent increase in draft is the final draft is 2082.93 and initial was 1960 when there is no side draft. In this case, there might be side draft because it's pulling at an angle. Therefore, 2082, we are not bothered about what is side draft or not because it will be taken care by the QH, all the parasitic forces, there is the imbalance forces will be there. Percent increase in draft will be equal to 2082.93 minus 1960 in the initial draft divided by initial into 100, that will be percent increase will be 6.27%. This is the answer for this problem. Therefore, when the plow is pulled at an angle of 10 degree, there will be increase in draft, that is 6.27%. Hope you understand this problem. Goodbye.